Hi everyone, I'm Maria and I'm a copywriter at Oxylabs. I believe we all are familiar with the situation when we enter some website on the internet and it asks us to prove that we are human. Solving weird puzzles with fire hydrants may seem like an odd way to prove you are an actual human being and have consciousness, but it won't seem that odd after watching this video. Today we'll discuss CAPTCHAs, how they work, why websites use them, and how to avoid them while doing web scraping jobs. Let's get started. So what does CAPTCHA mean? It's an acronym for Completely Automated Public Turing Test to Tell Computers and Humans Apart. As the name suggests, the purpose of CAPTCHA is to differentiate humans from bots. Most traditional CAPTCHA tests rely on vision, as computers are not as sophisticated as humans when it comes to processing visual information. Some common CAPTCHA types stretch and distort letters or numbers and ask users to identify the text. Other types of CAPTCHA present different images to users. The database of CAPTCHAs is massive in order to suggest as many different variations as possible. But what is the main purpose of CAPTCHAs? CAPTCHAs are primarily used to protect websites from malicious acts. Many internet sites do not want to be abused by bots and therefore ask users for CAPTCHA validation. To be more precise, there are several ways in which the CAPTCHA test can be used. For example, free email platforms may use CAPTCHAs to prevent malicious bots from sending spam advertisements from many different email addresses. Ticket sellers also often use the CAPTCHA test. Resellers sometimes employ bots to get a bunch of tickets to the most popular events mere seconds after their release, and later sell them for a larger price. CAPTCHAs help stop these bots. Another common threat is distributed denial of service attacks. Attackers aim to intentionally disrupt services by sending a large number of requests to one target. Websites employ CAPTCHAs to avoid potential attacks that may stop their services. You might have heard about reCAPTCHA and wondered how it's different from CAPTCHA. reCAPTCHA is a service from Google that performs the same function as a regular CAPTCHA. Many websites use this as a free web protection solution. You may have noticed reCAPTCHAs that only ask users to tick a box rather than solve a puzzle. These are called no-CAPTCHA reCAPTCHA. After ticking the box, if the system is still not convinced that the user is a human being, you will be asked to prove it again. But what exactly triggers CAPTCHA? If the system suspects that the user is a bot, then a CAPTCHA test shows up. It can be triggered by, for example, sending too many requests to the same target. reCAPTCHAs seem to be more sophisticated. While it's not exactly clear what triggers reCAPTCHAs, there are several potential factors, such as mouse movements, tracking cookies, browsing history. Solving CAPTCHAs may be a real headache. Being blocked or getting CAPTCHAs are some of the most common challenges while web scraping. These challenges can interrupt large-scale public data gathering operations. However, there are a couple of best practices you can stick to in order to avoid CAPTCHAs. First, use rotating proxies. Rotating your IP makes it harder for websites to recognize your IP footprint if you send multiple frequent requests. Second, change your user agent. Many websites are more favorable to certain bots than others. If your bot is not one of the supported bots, you should conceal your real identity by modifying your user agent to the one of a popular web browser. And lastly, use website crawler tools. Web crawler solutions such as the one offered by Oxylabs help to deliver requested data without any IP bans or CAPTCHAs. Companies can smoothly collect publicly available information at scale and focus on public data analysis rather than data gathering. Now let's quickly wrap everything up. As we've learned, CAPTCHAs are used to differentiate humans from bots and thus protect websites from malicious acts. However, CAPTCHAs may be a real challenge for web scraping, especially on a large scale. To avoid captchas while web scraping, you can rotate your proxies and user agents or use website crawler tools. This is pretty much it about captchas. You can also read our blog post on this topic for more information. If you have any questions, you can contact us via hello@oxylabs.io. And if you enjoyed this video, share it and subscribe to our channel for more useful content.